Each time a man stands up for an ideal, or acts to improve the lot of others, or strikes out against injustice, he sends forth a tiny ripple of hope, and crossing each other from a million different centers of energy and daring, those ripples build a current which can sweep down the mightiest walls of oppression and resistance.
Amidst the busy cubicles of the aviation electronics company Rockwell Collins, conversations about components of F-22 fighter jets often take a surprising turn. How are Frankie and John? Is a common question. I spotted school supplies on sale, so I picked up a few notebooks for Frankie, someone else offers. Hey, I saw you guys at the breast cancer walk, comes a shout from across the room. The attention is directed at Barb Driscoll. She's been putting together aircraft electrical systems for 2 decades, but her heart is in her second job. Barb is a direct support professional with REM Iowa Community Services in Cedar Rapids. I think my work with John and Frankie has helped people put minor challenges into perspective, said Barb of her colleagues at Rockwell. Sometimes people need to see another side of life. That's exactly what Barb does for Frankie and John, the 2 young men who thrive in her care. Amusement and water parks, movies and apple orchards are just some of the places that they've been. Barb pushes them to make sure they take full advantage of what she knows they can do, explained Tom Johnson, REM's program director in Hiawatha and Barb's nominator. She thinks outside the box. Making sure Frankie and Johnny are tech savvy is one of Barb's top priorities. Both are nonverbal. She remembers the days before iPads. John was unable to communicate outside of pointing, tapping, and leading staff by the hand. Frankie had a written vocabulary of approximately 12 words. Thanks to Barb's patient tutorials, both young men now use apps and websites to convey their wants and needs. Frankie can craft full sentences on his iPad, and John has created his own internet language. For example, if Barb sees the University of Iowa Hospital on his screen, she knows John isn't feeling well. If she sees J.C. Penney, she knows he's hoping for a trip to watch the escalators. It's Barb's joyful celebration of life's ups and her brave determination in its downs that are her greatest gifts to John and Frankie and to her colleagues who find such inspiration in her. When John graduated from high school last spring, Barb threw a party at the REM group home where John lives to celebrate. She invited teachers, staff, friends, and family. John proudly led guests around his decorated house. He pointed out photos in the scrapbook that Barb had made for him. Everyone savored the enormous spread of food she had prepared. These experiences take Barb back to her mother's childhood reminders to appreciate her many blessings. I see what she was trying to teach me, mused Barb, who's followed her mother's example. Her mother appreciates Barb's commitment. In fact, at 87, Barb's mom recently convinced her church to purchase a new wheelchair for John. Family is important to Barb. That's why she's made such an effort to connect with Frankie, or to connect Frankie with his. He had no family contact before Barb joined REM. Today, she and Frankie drive once a month to visit his grandfather in a veterans home, halfway between Cedar Rapids and Des Moines. Their first visit was tearful. "That's my baby boy," cried his grandfather, who never thought he would see Frankie again. "I knew then that we'd keep this up," said Barb. She also facilitates visits with Frankie's other family members. When Barb isn't working, which is rare, she and her family enjoy Iowa football. On a crisp fall day, you'll find her at Kinnick Stadium in Iowa City, donned in the Hawkeyes' gold and black. They don't miss a home game. when the band plays On Iowa and the 70,000 plus in the stadium starts singing, they might as well be looking at Barb. A heritage to us you did unfold. Love of family, love of friend, love of country too, makes us proud for what you stand, our dear old gold. For making us proud, Barb, with your creative commitment to those you serve, for always looking for opportunities to enrich, entertain, and engage, and for bringing the joy of family to your consumers and your colleagues, I'm proud to present you with the Ripple of Hope Award.